Hi, I'm Sjouke Bootsma. I'm currently Director for Supply Chain Management at Tedet. I started with Tedet some 13 and a half years ago. First, I was responsible for the asset management department in the Netherlands. Then I became responsible for the large projects department in the Netherlands. And since 2 years, I've become director for the supply chain for the whole of Tedet. Before this, I had management functions in other infrastructure operations companies like ProRail, and a background also in consultancy. My background from knowledge-wise is I'm an aerospace engineer and also I have a master's degree in change management. Well, there are a lot of quality systems like ISO 9000 or 9001. I think almost everybody knows them. But if you look at companies like Tenet, where we manage a lot of assets and where we build assets, I think the ISO 55000 fits better to our processes and also our assets. That's one. And the other aspect was also an external reason. The regulator in the Netherlands demanded Tenet to have, let's say, a quality system that fits to our primary task. So that was the reason. The second reason why we implemented this. The third reason was that it is, of course, of the most. It's very important that we stay in control of our assets and our processes alike. Indeed, power transformers are very, very important. If they fail, everything, the whole system can fail. The same applies also to HVDC components, etc. So it's not only the transformers, but especially in the DC area, also converters are of the utmost important. And since they are, I think, our utmost primary components, it's really important that they are reliable, that they perform like we want them to perform, and that also we got, let's say, proactive indications of the condition if a failure could appear. So it's always better to prevent these failures, and I think, let's say, condition monitoring and other techniques will help us here. But it's only of value if it's also if these methods are also part of, let's say, processes where we plan, do, check and act whether or not the condition needs refurbishment or whatsoever. So it's not only about the techniques, it's also about the processes. I think that depends on the scope. In the Netherlands we choose to the broader scope, let's say from boardroom up until the operations and maintenance. That's very important. I just called that line of sight, so that's also very important. So don't focus only on the assets as such. And I also think a very, very important fundament is your data management. Do you have all the data at hand? Is your data reliable? And if you don't have that, I think it will become a real challenge to implement the ISO 55000. So data management, data management, and data management. Yeah, if we focus on the power transformer, I think the first thing is the aging of the equipment. A lot of equipment was installed 10, 20 or 30 years ago. That's one aspect we have to take into account. On the other side, we also have to take into account that since the in-feed of renewable energies increases, also the use of our assets has become more dynamic. That's also important. And on the other hand, also what we like to prevent is having, let's say, Monday morning assets and Friday afternoon inspections. So the quality of our processes should always be good and in place. First of all, I think the outcome of your inspections and condition monitoring can become more transparent. That's the first thing. Also, more fact-based, although the experience of your working people still is very important. But this more objective approach will help us also to have, let's say, a more predictable performance of our assets. Not only now, but also in the near future. So we can also, by analyzing, define the best, let's say, the most effective and efficient countermeasures to prevent our assets from failing. Yeah, if I look at the outside world, and also referring to my background as an aerospace engineer, I think a lot has been developed, especially in the aerospace and nuclear industry. So, for instance, if you look at the old Boeing 707, they needed around 2 times more maintenance than the current airplanes. So, if you look at especially the aerospace industry, it has become of the essence to have, let's say, transparent and predictable condition monitoring to improve the performance of their assets. And I think we can also learn from these kind of industries. So, that's also what I see nowadays, that we introduce a lot of these techniques and also systems and processes in our own business. And I think that's a great idea. Well, the most important assets, it depends on where you look at. For, let's say, the more conventional AC grid, of course, transformers. But if you look nowadays and the fast development of DC technology, especially for our offshore business and our new connections in Germany, converter technology has also become of a very important aspect of life cycle management. So, therefore, we need to focus on this life cycle management, and it's not only about, let's say, having the tools, but also having it embedded in a well-functioning quality system like ISO 55000. One of the dilemmas we faced in the Netherlands when we introduced ISO 55000, we were one of the first asset management companies in the Netherlands at all, was also the question, why should we do it? Because you have to invest a lot of money, it takes a lot of attention, etc., etc. And does it really add value? Well, if I look back now, I came to the conclusion that indeed it adds value. We have our processes, end-to-end process, more into sight. We are more in control, and it does take less effort also to convince our regulator that we are in control of our business. So therefore, I think it's worthwhile the investment. And I hope you will see, look back at it in a couple of years, that you have exactly the same experience. Not only for us as standard, but also I think very important to implement ISO 55000 along the supply chain. So we have to rely on, let's say, the processes of our main suppliers, which you are one of us. So therefore, I think it's also important that we implement also this more into the, let's say, asset managing chain. And I wish you a lot of success with the introduction and also keeping this ISO 55000. First time is the more easy part, but keeping it and becoming more of a learning organization, that's a real challenge. I wish you a lot of success.